Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Citizens Bank Park and Phillies baseball. And today, the Phillies will host the Arizona Diamondbacks in a little match of a three-game series.
Welcome your 2015 Philadelphia
Phillies are about to take the field. Last two matchups there. Phillies won last night's game 3-2. Arizona took the first game by the score of 5-4. And Ethan Martin will be on the mound. And this one is the lineup for the Diamondbacks. Martin, 2-1, he's on the mound. A 1.27 ERA, 19 strikeouts, and 7 walks. And A.J. Pollock will lead it off, batting at 236.
Center fielder, number 11, A.J. Pollock.
Called strike, no balls and one strike.
First pitch, 136.
Ball. 78 degrees at game time.
Come on.
One ball and two strikes. Ethan Martin has a blazing fastball that is hit foul on the left side. He has that fastball that is overpowering and is tough for teams to hit. And there you see it. One strikeout for Martin. Take a look. Very hard for opponents to hit him. And as you see, in the last couple of games, he hasn't given up no more than 2 runs a game.
0-1.
The ball's in one strike. And Cartier batting at 255, the left fielder. That one is in the right field. That's the first hit of the game. Martin will give up his share of hits. He gave up only one hit. And one of his starts is Paul Goldsmith. Goldsmith in the series is 1-for-7. With 3 strikeouts. No balls and one strike. Runner goes, and that one is foul. Got him. 2 strikeouts to Martin, 2 down here in the first. Bring up Mark Trumbo, batting at 205. Runner goes, a throw on the second, and he got him. John Cartier tried to steal, got thrown out trying. We go to the bottom on the first. Diamondbacks nothing, the Phillies coming to bat. Ryan Sandberg and the Phillies. Ready, and here is Benny Bear. Bear batting at 244. And with Bear in the right field, a base hit. So the leadoff hit for Benny Bear in the bottom of the first.
Batting second, second baseman, Chase Utley.
And it'll bring up Chase Utley. Utley batting at 278, four home runs, 18 RBIs. Rivera is a threat on the base pads. And Utley sends in one in the center field. As well hit, but it'll stay in the park for the center fielder, and they'll put it away. One down here in the first. A.J. Pollock with the catch.
Batting third, right fielder, Brandon Jordan.
It'll bring up Brandon Jordan. Jordan had a double in last night's game, knocking in a run. Ball and no strikes. Fly ball as well hit the right field, pretty well hit this ball. It can't get it. It bounces off the right field fence. And Rivera will go to third, Jordan at second with a stand-up double. It was off the glove of Trumbo. Jordan hit well to right field. That bounced off the fence, off the scoreboard. And the Phillies have two on with one out. Let's see if the Phillies could take advantage here. Knock in a couple runs. Howard fouls it. And a big cut. Howard, this is going to get a run home. An RBI ground out for Howard. Phillies playing small ball. They lead it 1-0 here in the first. So give Howard an RBI batted in. They'll bring up Adrian Beltre. He's batting at 247. Only batting 195 on the road. He does have a home. Excuse me, only batting 195 at home. 362 on the road. That is a base hit. That's going to go all the way to the wall. Jordan scores. Rivera on his way to second with a stand-up double, and the Phillies lead it 2-0 here in the first inning. Give Adrian Beltre an RBI. Dominic Brown batting at 229, 7 home runs, 11 RBIs. Brown, this is in the gap to left field. That's going to go all the way to the wall. Beltre scores. Dominic Brown on his way to second. He is safe. A sliding double for Brown, and the Phillies lead it 3-0. Phillies hitting the ball early on here. This one bound goes all over the water. Phillies are hitting the ball pretty well. RBI double for Dominic Brown. Here's Darren Ruff. Ruff hits this one on the ground. This is going to end the inning. But the Phillies get three runs in the inning. They leave one left. We go to the second, 3-0 Philly. Here's Mark Trumbo. He's batting at 205.
Arizona, the right fielder number 15, Mark Trumbo.
And he hits a foul, no balls and one strike. Nothing in two.
Ball.
A little bit inside. One ball and two strikes. Martin's got that overpowering fastball. It's just tough for opponents to hit.
Inside ball.
Two balls and two strikes. Hit on the ground. Nice play by Utley. And fires over the first for the out. And NL East standings. Phillies are a game back on the Marlins. Washington behind Atlanta and New York. There's Aaron Hill. Batting at 225. That over. No balls and one strike. Beats a foul. Got him. Third strikeout for Martin. Two down in the second, and they'll bring up Gerald Laird. He's batting at 231. Bounced up there, no one ball and no strikes.
That's a ball. Two balls, no strikes. Ball.
3-0 to count now. Chris Owings waits on deck.
Yeah.
Got that over. The foul, so the count runs full. Got him. Four strikeouts for Martin, and that'll retire the Diamondbacks here in a second. They go in order. We go to the bottom of the second, 3-0 Phillies. Here's Andres Blanco batting at 189. One home run on the season. Blanco hits it foul.
Two
balls and two strikes. Outside, 1-2.
Come on, Bill. 2-2.
2-2 to count. Martin's still alive here. He fouls it. Two balls and two strikes. Got him. Blanco strikes out. One down here in the second. We'll bring up Ethan Martin, who was batting at 250. Up there, 1-0.
One ball, one strike.
Ooh, Martin way out in front of that. Little topper. Martin's thrown out. Two down. Here's Ben Rivera, who singled and scored a run his first time up. there, hits this one, caught by the shortstop, and that'll end the inning. Phillies go in order in the bottom of the second. We go to the third. Phillies lead it 3-0. Chris Owings leads off the third.
Leading off for the Diamondbacks, shortstop Chris Owings.
Switch. No, that missed. That's a ball.
That is a ball. One ball and
no
strike.
Take one.
1-1. Pizza foul is 1-2. Hit to Howard. Howard has to hurry and goes over to Martin for the out. There's one down.
Gonna
bring up Jamie Roman. Batting at 225 with 5 home runs and 19 RBIs. Head over for a strike. It's a foul.
Nope, ball.
Ball one. Phillies will head to Colorado after this game. 5 strikeouts for Martin. He is mowing them down here. Just giving up one hit. There's the pitcher now. Got that over.
One and one.
Almost hit him. One ball and one strike.
Ooh. One ball, 2 strikes.
Fans anticipating another strikeout here. Fouled it off. Balls and 2 strikes. Staying alive and it's foul. Got him. 6 strikeouts for Martin. Ryan Sandberg's got to be loving that. Ethan Martin mowing him down here. 2-3. Phillies lead it 3-0. Here's Chase Utley. Utley smacks this one in the gap to right center field, and that's going to go all the way to the wall. Utley will end up at second. A stand-up double for Chase Utley. He's tied for third with 6 doubles. Adrian Beltre leads the Phillies with 10. Jordan with 8. There's Brandon Jordan. He doubled and scored a run. Phillies are hitting their share of doubles in this one. He's a foul. No balls and 1 strike. Phase one down and in, down and outside, excuse me, 0-2. Well, we head to Colorado. Games. Jordan in the right field, that's a base hit. Utley will go to third. I was going to say, the first 2 games of the Rockies will not be on Video Game Network. But then games 3 and 4, And then four more games after that will be on the Phillies Network, Video Game Network, and one on UPN 57. Here's Ryan Howard, and Howard fouls it. Phillies have two on, nobody out. Here in the third. Howard fouls it. No balls and two strikes. Howard right to the shortstop. Chris Owens. One out. In the third inning, and they'll bring up Adrian Beltre. Beltre doubled his last time up, and he scored the run. And Beltre skies this a pop-up. And two outs. There's Dominic Brown. He doubled and knocked in a run. Foul by Brown. No balls and one strike. And two, runners went, but Brown fouled it. And Brown strikes out. Phillies get the first two hits, but could not score a run in the third. Matt Bashkirchen comes away in the fourth. 3-0 Phillies.
Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. Now he runs up and gets this one down. And the throw will be too late, so it's a bunt single to get him started here.
The left fielder, number 5, Ender Inciarte.
Ender Inciarte will stand in, and we'll see what they've got him doing here after the bunt single to start things out.
Hey, try turning the double play for one.
Now the first pitch. Ooh, started him with the change, and it's nothing in one.
A lot of these guys have come into these at-bats trying to be the aggressor, trying to make something happen. But what has happened is that they've swung and missed themselves into some early holes.
He's set, now the pitch. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. He waits, now the pitch. Fouled back. Here's another 0-2. Hit hard but fouled to the left, and they'll try it again. Here comes another 0-2. And they really bunch him up on that one. He swings and misses for the first out. So with a runner at first and one gone, time to bring in our pitch speed comparison for these two starters. And folks, that is not a misprint. He's been clocked at over 100 miles an hour so far. My goodness. Paul Goldschmidt will try it again. Set down on strikes his first time. And he'll start him with a slider that's taken down and away for ball one.
One and one.
On a great pitch there, caught in reach, and it's one and one. Comes set, now the pitch. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. No runs, two hits, no errors so far for the Diamondbacks. 2-1 pitch is a slider taken for a called strike two. Pause, now the pitch. Breaking ball, that's in the dirt as he takes a ball.
Now the question, do you send the guy on 3-2 with one out? You figure you're going to get something around the plate.
And awfully close there on 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball four.
Mark Trumbo
will stand in. He grounded out his first time. And this is going to be a foul ball. He's ready now. The pitch. And that swung on and fouled straight back. He's ready. Now the pitch. Just a touch outside. One and two.
Still now on one and two, you don't have to make the perfect pitch out there. The count is...
And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit. And that'll put him on the board as it's now a 3-1 contest.
Well, the offense for these guys has kind of been like you, Steve, all year long. Been on vacation. They didn't get much going yesterday at all. They've been shut down pretty well in this one, too. But finally, a little hope as they're on the board here with the RBI single.
Aaron Hill will stand in for the second time as he watches one miss low. It's a ball and no strikes. Runners are at first and third, one away. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground, but a foul ball, one and one. The 1-1. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1.
And one thing you can't do here, you cannot lose him and load the bases. He's still got a couple pitches to play with, and I'd expect this one to be somewhere in the strike zone.
2-2. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame.
So far, that's been the tale of this game in a nutshell. Way too many pitches being swung at out of the strike zone. I mean, it's almost getting comical now. And if I'm pitching on the mound, I wouldn't throw anything close to the strike zone.
Standing in now, Gerald Laird, as the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. That man's team has definitely shot itself in the foot with all the strikeouts so far.
It seems like it's been a growing trend so far, but man, you just got to be able to put the ball in play when you've got runners in scoring position.
Here it comes, 2-1. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1 from the belt. Kicks and deals. And here's a ball hit in the air. And Beltre will make the catch to retire the side. Only one in the inning for Arizona. On now to the bottom half of inning number 4. It's the Phillies 3 and the D-backs 1. Cameron Rupp will lead things off here in the home half of the 4th. Now the first pitch. In the air to right center. Pollock is there to make the catch, and the home half of the 4th starts with a one pitch out.
Boy, these are the kind of days where even I want to grab a bat. Everybody on that offense has hit the ball hard somewhere.
Andres Blanco will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. And he'll go after the second pitch of the inning as this is on the ground over to first. And the underhanded throw gets him for the out.
Well, that's a nice backhand play right there. Towards the hole, he has to beat his pitcher to the bag, and he does it to perfection.
Ethan Martin will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Hit hard to short. On to first, and can you believe it? A three-pitch inning. And just like that, the side is retired. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. But they hang on to a 3-1 lead. Chris Owings will make his way towards the box to lead off the 5th. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. First two pitches off the mark here. It's 2-0.
And I think with no one on base, you know, this is a guy you need to come after. I certainly wouldn't be afraid to give him a fastball here.
And the 5th inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Not the most convincing way to start an inning right here. You're going to see him try to hold back, but he winds up making contact anyway. Sort of an excuse me swing right there. And this is just an easy chance here on the mound. And that's a quick first out.
Into the box now, Jamie Romack. As he'll take a look at ball one. Now here it comes. Change up low, 2-0. Here it comes. Pretty good cut there, but it's to 2-1 now.
but you get the sense that what they need is one big hit from anybody in the lineup. If they could get one, it could get them right back in this game, because right now they just seem out of it.
Now a ball hit fouled off to the right and up into the crowd. 3-1 our score as we play inning number 5. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd, foul. The 3-2 one more time. And awfully close there on 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball 4.
Yeah, they went to the slider there on 3-2, and that's a pitch where you're really hoping the hitter will see fastball and swing through it. But it didn't work out that time. He winds up losing him.
From the belt, the pitch. And they will have him bunting with one away as he gets this one down. Wow, the throw pulls him off the bag. And he is in there.
And you know what? This is always a really difficult throw for a first baseman, because he has to deal with the runner who's headed to second base. And also, that runner can sometimes screen the shortstop that's covering the bag. And in the end, this one gets thrown away.
A.J. Pollock will dig in now following the error, and it's almost as though they've been given a lifeline here to get back into this game.
Oh, they've been handed a golden opportunity. You got to find a way to make that one hurt.
And that misses 1-1.
Yeah, he's not really getting on top of that curveball right now, and that's going to get him into trouble if he keeps leaving.
Just a sec now as that ball finds its way into the outfield, a base hit. And they will hold that runner over at third as he'll move up only 90 feet, but the bases are loaded with one away. Ender Inciarte will stand in now in one of the bigger at-bats of the ballgame to this point, as he'll do so with the bases loaded.
And that key hit still hasn't shown up yet. Like you say, you've got the bases loaded. You just wonder, how many more of these opportunities are you going to get?
Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. Beltre is able to look this one in just past the third base dugout, and that's out number 2.
And now that would have fallen under the infield fly rule if it was a fair ball. No matter. Goes over to make the catch here in foul territory.
Paul Goldschmidt stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0.
Here at the plate, you just need to be thinking base hit here. A grand slam, that'd be sweet, but a single should be enough to tie up this game.
And he chases after ball 3, and instead it's 2-1.
And that had all the looks of a guy who was going to take a giant hack, 2-0, no matter where that pitch was. DK, I know you never did that.
Not me.
And the run will score from third to make this a 3-2 ball game.
Well, you know all the infielders are taught to try and knock a ball down in that RBI situation. But here on the mound, I don't think he had any choice. This one comes back at him and gets him flush. By the time they all scramble around to find the ball, they have no chance of preventing that run from scoring.
Here's Mark Trumbo now, as he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike 1.
Yeah, you know, when a pitcher gets into a little bit of a jam out there, you can bet he's going with his best stuff. So we may see a heavy dose of that slider right now.
Lays off the slider, and it's 1-1. Swing and a grounder fouled, and that almost took the first base coach along with it. Here comes the 1-2. And he's got himself another one. He picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. A run on a couple of hits here for Arizona. Home half of the 5th coming up. It's the Phillies 3 and the Diamondbacks 2. Ben Revere will step in now to lead off the inning as his guys look to maybe break the rut they've been stuck in.
Yeah, and after that first inning, it's been all zero since. And once he kind of got settled into that groove, he's been a difficult nut to crack.
And this is fouled back and out of play. And the pitch. Hit softly to the right side. Throw, and he's called out on a close play at first. Shea Sutley will dig in. He doubled his last time. And here's the first pitch. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. Throw to first, and Utley's retired, 2 gone.
Yeah, and he had to range deep for this one. And you've also got to worry about that ball hitting the lip of the outfield grass. So You got to hang with it, just like he did, and he made a nice play.
Into the box, Brandon Jordan, as he will swing at the first pitch and send a ground ball out to short. And that's through, a base hit.
Well, he'd had some high-stress innings here so far. It was looking like he turned a corner and was on his way to a much-needed 1-2-3, but he's going to have to get in the stretch here after all.
So a runner at first here with two gone in the inning, and digging in, slugging first baseman Ryan Howard. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. The next pitch, and this will be fouled away. Ready now on 1-1. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. The right-hander deals on 1-2. And he grooves the fastball there. This is hit high and deep out to straightaway center field. Leaps, and he makes the catch. He took away a home run. Wow. Another look here as he goes up and over the wall to take away a home run. More to come on the show Sunday Baseball after this. Aaron Hill will walk toward the plate as he'll lead things off here in the Arizona sixth inning.
Second baseman, Aaron Hill.
Oh, and that one slung through the strike zone that time at 98, 0-1. For that man right there, you need look back only to his last start to see a performance like the one he's shown here so far.
And well on his way to another great outing. And that's what you get when you mix your speeds and throw a lot of strikes.
And this is fouled straight back. The next 0-2. Takes a good swing, but this will be a foul ball. Another 0-2 home. Out in front of a fastball as this is ripped down the left. Hill round second. He'll try for third. And he will make it up to third base, as that is a gift there off of what was a terrible throw.
Well, I think this was going to be two bases for sure, but then all heck breaks loose getting it back in. He winds up taking third on the throwing error.
In now, Gerald Laird, off speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Now some action in the Phillies bullpen as a right-hander begins to crank it up out there. Now Laird waits for the 1-0. This is foul right side. 1-1 on the way. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. From the stretch. Late swing here as this is hit hard to the right side. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Sets the 2-2 pitch. And he struck him out. The 10th victim sat down on strikes thus far.
Not only is that 10 strikeouts now, but I'll tell you what, we've still got a few innings to go here. He keeps throwing the way he is. He can make that number really interesting by the time this one's through.
Chris Owings will stand in again. A couple of groundouts for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. He'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one.
No, that's
outside. Off the plate again, and it's 2-0. Any thought to bringing the infield in here with one away?
Still a little early in my book. A run you can live with. What you don't want to do is let this snowball into a big inning.
Good fastball that time as he's pulled the count back to even now. It's 2-2. 3-2 is our score here in inning number six. Here he comes on 2-2. And this ball is also hit foul and heading for the seats, so we'll have to do it again. Still 2-2. Now a little dribbler up the line to first. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Now a swing and a ball pulled down the line to third. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile the runner is in to score.
And here, he knows all he needs is a ground ball to tie this thing up. So that's all he's really shooting for, and he gets it done.
Now here's the first pitch. Here's a swing and a ground ball. This is foul for the first strike. And now pitch on the way. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. Now here's the pitch. And he'll take a look at a strike on the inside corner. It's one and two. One of the things that makes him so tough to hit, the ability to put his pitches right on the black.
Yeah, I mean, you watch the catcher's glove on some of these, and it literally...
And we'll have to leave it there, as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. So one run on one hit, one error, and no one left. The 5, 6, and 7 slots due up in the bottom of inning number six, and we are all tied at 3 apiece. Adrian Beltre will be the batter as we get things going in the bottom of the sixth. First pitch coming. Swing and a ball chop foul down the left side. Here's the pitch. Here's a ball lifted out to Trumbo in right field. One gone. Dominic Brown will step in, 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Now here's the first pitch. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1.
And I wish more guys would pitch like this. I mean, look at that pitch count right there. That is really low for this stage of the game, and it's because he's throwing strikes and challenging guys.
Oh, got him a swing out of his shoes on that one, 0-2.
And it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world here to mix in a take every now and again.
And this is lined into left field, and that'll get down for a base hit, his second of the afternoon.
Well, they just kept going away, 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 and then finally he just said, might as well hit it to the opposite field. So that's a great approach right there, and it nets him a base hit.
Cameron Rupp step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. Here's the first offering. First pitch of the at-bat is lifted in the air out to left. Inciarte is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out.
Now batting, shortstop, Andres Blanco.
Andres Blanco will dig in for the third time now. He struck out and bounced out in his first two trips.
Come on, Phillies!
First pitch to him.
Here we go.
Swung on and lifted down the left field line. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. Seventh inning coming up, and we are all tied at 3 apiece.
Seventh inning, Pacheco the pinch hitter. Ethan Martin is still in the game. Let's see what he does here. He has thrown over 100 pitches. No balls and one strike.
1-1.
One and two. Got him. Call third strike. That's 12 strikeouts for Ethan Martin. He is going to try to go one more inning. His A.J. Pollock. A career high, 121 pitches. He is going to try to go in the seventh inning and then be taken out for a pinch hitter. Hopefully giving him a chance to win the game if the Phillies can do something in the seventh. Fly ball right field. That's going to go up to the wall. Jordan plays it. And the ball is cut off. It'll be a double. Here's Ender and Cartier.
Ender in Enciarte.
Enciarte. Keep saying Encarte. That is a strike. No balls and one strike.
Oh. One ball, one strike.
It's a foul. Outside, two balls and two strikes. Well, they're going to make Martin throw as many pitches as he can. That ball's hammered. Hit pretty well. That's going to go over the wall. The Diamondbacks is going to take the lead. And you would think that'll be all for Ethan Martin. And that will be. So the Diamondbacks take a 4-3 lead here in the seventh inning. And that'll probably be all for Ethan Martin. So Sandberg will come out and make the pitching change. He pitches 6 3rd. Gives up 4 runs. So he's on the hook for right now. Kevin slowly into the game. Here's Paul Goldsmith. Phillies had 3 runs in the first, but that's all they were able to get. Hellickson has pitched well after the first. Throw over the third, and he is, no, they call him safe. They call him safe. Ryan Howard was robbed of a home run his last time up. The Phillies had their opportunities. Go over the first for the out here, holding the runner at third. Nice job by Beltre to hold the runner. Two outs in the seventh. And they'll bring up Mark Trumbo. No balls and one strike. That ball is hit in the left field of base hit. Jordan was playing deep. And the Diamondbacks get another run. And it is 5-3 now here in the seventh inning. So the Diamondbacks really doing a number here after being down 3-0 early in the first. Looks like the Phillies are going to run all over with this one. But Hellickson calmed down. The Phillies did have the opportunities to blow it open. Oh, no. That ball's hammered well. Shorten puts it away. And that'll retire the side. That ball like was carrying well. But the Diamondbacks take the lead with 2 runs here in the seventh. They go to the bottom of the seventh. It's 5-3.
Your attention, please.
Brad Ziegler will come into the game.
Number 29, Brad Ziegler.
Xavier Paul will be the pinch hitter.
For the Phillies, number 28, Xavier Paul.
Phillies will get the bullpen. Paul, that's a fair ball down the right field side. It's going to go to the wall. Paul, he's going to round first and go over to second, and he's in there. A good job and effort by Xavier Paul. A leadoff double here in the seventh. And they'll bring up Ben Revere. He is 1-for-3. He singled and scored the run. And the Phillies will get Ken Giles in the bullpen and Jonathan Papelbon. But there, a base hit in the center field. Paul rounding third. He will score, and it's now a 5-4 game. So Ben with there, an RBI single here in the seventh inning. It is now a 5-4 game. Diamondbacks lead is down to one. Well, a nice piece of hitting by Ben Revere, just right down the heart of the plate. Phillies have got their share of hits. Now the Diamondbacks are going to change their pitcher. Oliver Perez will come into the game. Here's Chase Utley. Utley skies this one in the left center field. And A.J. Pollock will put it away. One out here in the seventh inning. They'll bring up Brandon Jordan, who is 3-for-3, a double, and two singles. Jordan back up the middle. Oh, what a nice play, and they're going to get a double play. It looked like that ball was going to go in for a base hit, but Chris Owings did a good job of stopping it, turning the double play, and the Phillies. Opportunity goes to waste, but they do get a run. We go to the eighth. Ken Giles is the new pitcher. Xavier Paul is in the game. He'll play left field for Dominic Brown. Here's Gerald Laird. And one ball and no strikes. Two. Nice heat by Ken Giles. Ball's hit foul. Another foul. Two balls and two strikes. Fly ball center field. Revere coming on, and he'll make the play. Is one down here in the eighth. 12 strikeouts for Ethan Martin. Gave up 8 hits, gave up 4 runs, 5 runs, 4 earned runs, and 2 walks. Here's a ground ball to Blanco. It's two outs here in the eighth. Here's Jamie Romick. He is 0-2. A strike on Romick. High ball left field. Paul going back. Paul makes the catch in front of the wall. And that'll retire the Diamondbacks here in the eighth. We go to the bottom of the eighth. Diamondbacks up 5-4. Here's Ryan Howard.
Leading off for the Phillies. First baseman.
Howard was robbed of a home run in the fifth inning. Nice heat there. One ball is a one strike. And two. He throws that sinker. A very dangerous pitch. Howard, he got, they played the shift, and Howard's thrown out. is Adrian Beltre. He's 1-for-3. He doubled. Beltre fouls it. One ball and one strike.
Two and one
to count. Three balls and one strike. Giles waits on deck. Beltre skies it in the center field. And that'll be two outs. And Darren Ruff will be the pinch hitter. And they're pitching well here in the bottom of the eighth. Rupp hits it to deep right field. Could it be? It is out of here! Darren Rupp has tied the game here in the bottom of the eighth. Coming off the bench as a pinch hitter, he delivers a solo shot, and this game is tied at 5. Well, they got the heart of the order. And now Diamondbacks manager, he's going to make a double switch. Bring in Randall Delgado. Darren Ruff is third home run of the season. That ball is hit in the shallow center field, and that'll be caught. And that'll retire the Phillies, but Darren Ruff ties the game in the eighth. A solo shot, his third of the season, just getting over the fence.
Your attention, please. Now pitching
Jonathan Papelbon in the game. Here's Nick Ahmed, batting at 231. He is in the game now. So Papelbon. As the inning will work. Jake Diekman in the bullpen for the Phillies. No balls and two strikes. Ooh, fouled that one. He beats a foul. Got him. Ahmed strikes out, one down to bring up A.J. Pollock. He beats a foul, no balls and one strike. Ooh. Good heat for Papelbon, 0-2. Base hit to right field. Pollock with a one-out single is Edwin Esartier, and Papelbon trying to just get out of the inning. strike. Oh, that ball hit the left field. That ball is carrying well. Caught by Xavier Paul. Here's Paul Goldsmith. Had a good day. He takes a strike. 0-1. Runner goes. A throw on the second. It's in time. Alex caught stealing. And Papelbon gets out of the inning. We go to the bottom of the ninth. All tied up at 5 apiece. Here's Andres Blanco. Blanco's 0-6. He flew out in the sixth inning. Blanco hit on the right side. And Goldsmith takes it there, and it is one out here in the ninth. Here's Xavier Paul. He doubled and scored the run in the seventh inning. Paul back up the middle. That's a base hit in the center field. So Paul is on with a single. He's 2-for-2 since coming into the game. And it'll bring up Ben Revere. Revere is 2-for-4. Two singles and knocked in a run. Revere hits it on the right side. This is going to be a double. No, it won't be a double play ball. Revere is safe. Here's Chase Utley. I'll give him a ground out. Utley doubled in the third. Utley hits this one on the ground. And we are going to extra innings. We go to the 10th, tied up at 5. Well, Papelbon is in his second inning of work here. Papelbon fouls it. Excuse me. Oh, he fouls it. There's no balls and one strike. Here we go. 14 pitches for Papelbon. Ball's hammered to left. Xavier Paul coming along, can't get it. And Diamondbacks with a leadoff double here to begin the 10th inning. Paul Goldsmith with a double. And Diekman will come into the game. Diekman has not given up any runs this season. But the Diamondbacks have a runner on and nobody out. That is a strike. And you just want to get at least one out. No balls and two strikes. Nice slide, nice change up. And go with a first footy out as Trumbull grounds out. The plate. One down to bring up Aaron Hill. One strike to Hill. Powered in the center field, but Rivera puts it away. It's two outs here in the 10th. Two outs is Gerald Laird. Sinker, one ball and no strikes. Hit on the ground, the shortstop. Blanco throws him out, and that'll end the inning for the Diamondbacks. So a leadoff double But Papelbon gets off the hook. As we go to the bottom of the 10th, it's 5-5. Here's Brandon Jordan. He doubled and singled. He singled twice. Jordan back up the middle. A base hit in the center field. Jordan represents the winning run. And here is Ryan Howard. Howard 0 for 4. Grounded out in the eighth. That is a strike. Phillies with 13 hits. The Diamondbacks with 11. Howard foul. Justin DeFreitas up in the Phillies bullpen. Another foul by Howard, 0-2. Howard back up the middle. They're only going to get one out. Because of Jordan Speed, that ball was hit very slow. It'll bring up Adrian Beltre. Beltre is 1-4. Double. That was way back in the first inning. Oh, they're going to put Beltre on. They are not going to take any chances with Beltre. And they will have to bring in a pinch hitter. They'll put in Salvador Perez. Perez hitting the right field and it's going to drop it in the gap. Jordan has to go to third. They're going to try to bring him home. Jordan going to go home. The Phillies are going to win it by the score of 6-5. On an RBI double by Salvador Perez. He came into the game as a pitch hitter on the first pitch. He whacked it in the right center field and the Phillies win it by the score of 6-5 here in 10 innings. All right, and it's Jordan, the player of the game. He scores the winning run. Brandon Jordan with 4 hits in the game. 2 singles, 2 doubles. Excuse me, 1 double and 3 singles. Excuse me. And he scored the winning run. And the Phillies going to take 2 out of 3 over the Diamondbacks. As they win the game by the score of 6-5. We will talk to you in a couple of days when the Phillies take on the Rockies here in Colorado.